Hello guys, you welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be looking at the mechanism practical appropriately. But before we go on, I want to use this period to solicit for your assistance in setting up a mini lab where I can carry out every possible experiment with ease. I also have done this experiment for long, but I have to improvise and get some little material that my money is able to what covered. Although I usually write to school in order to make use of their lab, but this time around, because of the hoodlums we face in this country, majority of school fails to allow. Please, your assistance is quite needed. No amount is small. I dedicate this channel to teach physics and mathematics, both practically and theoretically. I know you are surprised, mathematics also have practical. If I'm able to set up my mini lab, I'm going to show you everything. Thank you as you assist. You find the details to the account at the right hand corner of the screen. I also wish to open a Patreon account, which I will also be doing very soon. Your assistance is what I really need. Thank you guys. Now let's go on to what we are doing today. Now remember, in our last video, I shared this question with you and I was like, this is 90% sure, certain question that will be asked by NECO on this particular what, on this particular experiment. Now, because of the shortage of apparatus, I could not cater for mass of 5 grams. I only have mass of 10 grams. So I'm going to vary the reading, although normally the reading is supposed to be, because NECO asks us to use, they ask us to use our mass W to be 30 grams. That is, we should label a mass W to be 30 grams. And we are to start our apparatus. That is, the value of M should range from 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and 30. But because of the shortage of the apparatus, I have to improvise. I'm making my W to be what? To be 50. Are we together? So my W is going to be 50. And also, my value will range from 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50 instead of this. But the exact exam, I'm very sure this is how the reading will go. Are we together? Thank you. If we are together, so let's just move on using this particular word, value. Now, you will have to follow up with me. Now, this is a pulley A, and this is a pulley what? Pulley C. Normally, these two pulleys have to be on a board, a drawing board, just like the one I have here. This is a what? A drawing board. And this drawing board is to be supported with retort stand. But because there's no retort stand, I have to improvise and make it like what? Like a force board. So I fix this leg during this weekend so that it can stand like it is retort stand. Okay? Do we get that now? So you have to use retort stand to hold this. And here is my what? Pulley A. And here is my what? Pulley B. Now, if we look at what? If we look at the board, AC, this dot line represents what? Represents the thread. And here is the thread that I pass over what? I passed it over the pulley, like you can see here now. Are we together? Now, we are also to put, we need to attach a loop of thread at the center of AC. Like if I have it in the question before, I'm going to share the question with you again on the screen. At the right hand corner of the screen, you find the question there now. So if you look at that now, so here is what? Here is that loop that will divide what? Line AC into two. Are we together? Okay. If we are together, what's the next thing that we are supposed to do is to fix what? Our drawing paper under what? This line, so that we can be able to trace it out, like I will be doing now. So my drawing paper is going to be like this. So I'm going to use my thumb pin to hold it like this, so that it's going to be stick to the drawing board. So I have it like this. Now that we have this now, what's the next thing that we are supposed to do as regard what the instruction given to us in this? Now, this is what will happen. I have to determine the value of what? Of this particular length, the length of this what? Of this rope on this particular paper. That is one. And two, I have to look for the midpoint. Now, for me to get what I'm looking for perfectly, all I just need to do is to suspend an anchor on this so that this rope is set to stretch. So if I do that, the rope is now what? That is, this thread is stretched now. So I'm going to pick my what? My biro and look for a distance from here to somewhere here and dot it. Are we there? So I'm from here to somewhere here and dot it also. Are we there now? So we can see those two dots now. So those two dots, I'm going to take my ruler. So if I have my ruler, I'll use my ruler to measure the distance between the two points. So if I can get the distance between the two points, that'll be the midpoint of the rope. Okay? So, although I have an imaginary line drawn here, so you can also draw an imaginary line there. So that imaginary line, the distance between them is 19. So 19 divided by 2, that will give me 9.5. So this gives me my midpoint. So what I will do next is I'm going to adjust this rope so that it will be at that center. Are we together? Okay. If we are together, remember, each mass here is 10 grams. So if I count this now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this represents mass W, which I told you that is supposed to be 30, but it's going to be 50 for this experiment. Are we together? Now, the question now says, I should start by putting what? A mass of what? 10 gram. Remember, it's supposed to be 5 gram, but I'll be using what? 10 gram. So if I put what? I have to use a weight anchor at this center as well, like this. Now, you can see now that this loop is actually at the center of these two dots. Are we together? Now, I'm going to put what? A mass of what? A mass of 10 gram and see what it will look like. So, when I put a mass of 10 gram, I will allow this rope to be at the center and this one also. You can see that it's not swinging again. Everything is at equilibrium now. So, what I will do next is I'm going to take what? This particular point here. Are we together? You can see I already took the point. So what I will do next is to remove this. So when I remove this, I'm done with the first reading like that. So what I will just do next is that I'm going to connect this point and connect this, then connect this. Then this line is going to divide this one into two before I take the normal measurement of what the axis to look for. That is, the value for Y, the value for AO, the value of what? Y all over A, so that I can tabulate my reading. So let's keep that aside. We do that as we move on. So let's go to the next reading now. Okay? So I'm to slot in the second what? The second paper. Okay? Sorry. So, if I slot in the second paper like this, so I will do the same thing by fixing this and fix this also. So, are we together? Okay, so I'll remove this so that I can take the dots on the rope here. So I have this, and I have that. Are we together? So, don't let us forget the distance between the two lines. So, our center still remain 9.5. So, what I'm going to do next is that I will increase the mass to 20. So this is 10 already. So when I put 20 on it, so you see now I'll take what? I will allow this one to settle down at the center like this. Then I'm going to take what? The dot. You make sure you don't drag. So I pick the dots like that. So I'm done with that. So I'll go for the next one, which is 30. I could not see the imaginary line on this. Okay. So you have to draw the imaginary line so that your work will be more easier and more accurate. Okay, so I have to do the same thing by getting this point, that is point A and C, and I use my ruler to determine the center, which is going to be 9.5. So the next thing is for me to suspend my mass such that it's going to be at the center like this. So I have to increase the mass by 10 again, so it will be 30. So all together, so I'll make sure it stands at rest. Then I pick my point. So I'm done with that of 30. So the next thing is to go for that of 50. Sorry, 40 rather. Okay. So to reduce this so that I can pick my points. Then the center, don't forget 9.5 centimeter. So I will increase this now to 50. So the mass now is 50. As you can see, so now that it's 50, we'll find this to be here. So I'll remove this as well. And then the next thing is to look for the last point. So I'm going to increase this to 50. You know, we just finished 40 now. So remember, I have my imaginary line somewhere here. Okay, so having done that, I'll check for my 9.5. What is there? So this line will be at the middle, and I'll increase the mass of this one to be 50. Sorry. So when I increase the mass to be 50, you see what happened? So this should be at the center. Okay. So if that should be the case, I take my point like that. So this is when it is 50 gram, when M is 50 gram, and this is when M is 40 gram. One it is 30 gram. And here is one it is 20 gram. So we have that of 10 gram also. So the next thing now is to connect all these points together. Then we see how we go about that. Okay guys, now that we have what connects the points, let's see what are the results. Now, if you look at this now, this is when the mass is 10 gram. So we have connected the dots. The dots we make here and the one we make here and the one we make here. So we connected the dots now. Then the question says we should take the measurement of what? AO. So we take the measurement from here to this place. And our AO happens to be 9.8 centimeter when the mass at the center is 10 gram. Remember, the mass here is always constant. Are we together? So if that should be the case, then our Y, which is the distance between what? OB. So that gives us 2.8 centimeter, and when we take the ratio of Y to what AO, we have 0.2857. I'll be explaining the relationship between each measurement now. So this is what when our mass is 20 gram. So when our mass is 20 gram, we have what AO to be 10.3 centimeter. Our Y is equals to 3.7. So you can see that as the mass is increasing, the value of Y is increasing, likewise the value of A, and we can see from the experiment. So here is our diagram. So we now look at it when M is 30 gram. So when M is 30 gram, you see now our Y is 5.10 and our AO is 10.8 centimeter. Then we take the ratio of the two. Likewise, when the value of what? When the value of M is 40 gram. Now, what is said to happen when the value of M equal 50 grams? So when the value of M equals 50 gram, you will see now that the body is going to be at equilibrium. Then you see the value of Y drastically reduced to 5.2, though the value of A still what increase as what AAO rather increased to be 11 centimeter. Now let us see what the examiner asks us to do with all this reading. Now, haven't got the reading, we are asked to tabulate our reading. So I think I can clean this now. So if we are to tabulate our readings, we have this to be our serial number. The experiment was repeated 5 times and the mass is already in gram. Then we have the value of our Y in centimeter, the value of our AO also in centimeter. Then we have the ratio of Y to AO to be dimensionless because centimeter and centimeter will cancel. So when this one is 10.0, you don't need to put the gram here. So this is 20.0 and this is 30.0. This is 40.0 and this is 50.0. Are we together? So Y, when the value of M is 10 gram, so what's the value of our Y? Our Y is 2.80. It's going to be in 2 decimal place now because it's a determined what reading. This one is going to be in 1 decimal place because it's given directly from the experiment. So AO is going to be 9.8 centimeter as well, just because we also determined that. Now, because we evaluate this one with our calculator, it's going to be in 4 decimal place, so 2857. So some I decided to put it at 3 decimal place. Yes, we are still in line, provided that you have this to be at least 3 significant figure. We have discussed that when I was talking about how to plot graphs, so you can check my video on that. So when the mass is now 20 gram, so what's the value of Y? When the mass is 20 gram, we have the value of AO to be 10.30 and the value of Y to be 3.70. Then when we take the ratio, we have 0.3592. So when M is now 30, what's the value? So we have that when M is 30, the value of Y is 5.10 and the value of A is 10.80. Okay, so well, we'll take the ratio. We have 0.4722. Okay, so the next one is, well, this one is 40. That is when the mass is 40 gram. So we have the value of Y to be 5.80. And we have the value of AO to be 11.40. And we have the value of our Y to be 0.5088. And amazing, when it is now what, 5, that is when it is 50, the value of Y is 5.20, and the value of AO is 11.00. Then the value of Y over AO is 0.4727. So here is our table. You can see there shouldn't be anything like what, canceling or shading on your table, otherwise you lose the mark. Now, what do they ask us to do now? We are asked to plot the graph of M against the graph of M against Y all over what? AO. Now, absolutely, when you plot your graph itself to be what? A straight line graph with an intercept on the y-axis. Now, let me give you some clue on how to know what your slope will look like. Although, I'm supposed to show you the way to manipulate this experiment, but it might be a bit tedious than to manipulate this experiment is actually difficult than doing it. So doing it is quite what, simple. If you just what, all you just need to do is that when you have your paper like this, just do what, draw an imaginary line at the two sides and make sure that whenever you are fixing your pulley, there is what, there is a space between the pulley and this book. If you look at it now, if I slot in what? If I slot in my drawing paper behind what? Behind the rope, you see that there is a space. It's very free. So try to create something of such, and also draw an imaginary line here. So this imaginary line will make it easy for you to determine the center, and it will make it easy for you to determine what point pulley A and that of C. So once you have that imaginary line, your work itself to go smooth. So no bother to think about to manipulate this experiment. And I will tell you the reason why it's very difficult to manipulate, because I'll show you now how you can tend to what, manipulate the experiment if you want to. Now let's look at something there. This particular rope now has a tension, and this particular other one also have a tension. So that is this particular one here. This is, there's a tension on this rope now. Supposing we are using string, there's a tension here. There's also what, a tension here. Now there is a relationship between this tension and this tension. Supposing they ask me to calculate for the total tension on this particular what, instrument, I have it to be theoretically, can I clean this now? Let's clean this so that we are going to see reason why it's difficult to manipulate this reading. Although I'll give us some hints on how to check if our result is actually correct or wrong. Now, let's quickly look at something, guys. If I have my diagram to be like this, like what I have it to be, and here is a string. Let's say this is T. This is another string, another T. So if the tension between this string is the same thing, why we keep changing the value for what, for the mass that we are suspending on it? Let's say this and this, they are of the same tension. If they are of the same tension, then we are going to add that 2t cos of theta is equal to the sum of the mass that we are putting on it. So guys, please pay maximum attention here. If at all you want to manipulate, remember, I already told you that our W for this experiment that we just concluded is 50. So if you put 50 here, when M naught is 30, is 10 rather, so you put 10 here, so it means you are going to be having 60 there. Now, how can you determine the value for T? You cannot determine for the value for T because you are not given, you need to look for that. Now, there's need for you to know the value of theta. It means you need to construct the angle here. So if I have my theta to be here, you need to know the value of theta. Do you need to bring your protractor before getting this? So there's need for you to draw it accurately so that if you get the value of theta here, you can then use this to find the value of t. And remember, since you are still using the same work, the same tension, the t will remain constant throughout the experiment. Now, let us substitute for the value for cos theta. If I'm to substitute for the value for cos theta, I will have that here is y and here is our what? AO. You will see if I say cos theta ka adjacent over hypotenuse. So I will have 2t equal what? Equal y all over what? AO. So if you look at this now, you see what this look like is equals to what? M naught plus W. So if you look at this now, if this thing is constant, that is, if 2t is constant, are we together, then you are going to see that, okay, let me take it like this. If 2t is a constant, and let me say y all over a naught is equals to what? Is equals to p. Then you will see that p is directly proportional to what? To m naught, because 2t is a constant. And that's to tell you that whenever you plot the graph of this mass and this together, you are said to have what? A straight line graph. But that is not what I really want to prove, but I just want to let you know that when you plot your graph, it's going to be what? A straight line graph. So let's back to what I'm trying to say. Now, I have to determine the value for y, and I have to determine the value for what? A naught. So if I make what? A naught the subject of the formula, A naught is said to be what? M naught plus what? W divided by what? 2t. So I will have the value for my A naught when this one is this. And y is said to become what? A naught into M naught plus W divided by what? 2t. So it means that if I'm going to manipulate, I have to be using this formula. But reason why this formula will not be useful is because I have to know the value for t. Now, let's take for instance that I already determined the value for my theta. This is the angle that I need to be constructing for every reading. It takes more time. And that is why you should not bother thinking of manipulating. But you just know this formula because that's the relationship between what? Between the tension and the mass that we are what? Changing here. Is that taken out? Should, in case you are giving a theoretical question under what? Under the practical. That aside, what happened? How can you know if your what? If your intercept is actually correct? Remember, your slope S is the same thing as saying 1 all over what? 2t. So your slope S is 1 over 2t. You can cross check that when you want. When you done, so it means when you plot your graph, you can use your graph to determine the tension on the string in case you are asked to do that. And your intercept, let me use I for our intercept, is going to be the constant what? The constant mass divided by what? 2t. So this will be the value for your what? For your intercept. Guys, this is going to be the end of today's lecture. So that's to tell you that don't bother to manipulate. The experiment is quite simple and very fast to achieve than manipulating it. Is that taken now? The only thing that might be making you think of manipulation is if and only the apparatus in your school is not sufficient enough, or you don't have apparatus for this particular experiment and you want to what? Manipulate. There's no point in doing that because it will consume more time. Kindly get the apparatus, or you just improvise like I do. After improvisation, everything I improvise here doesn't spend me more than 3k. So in Nigeria, what? Nigerian currency. So, and I was able to figure it out. So you can also what? You can quickly what? Do something of this. And that's why I don't make this experiment to be a day before what? Before the practical, so that you can know how to go about what? Improvising the apparatus that you need. Actually, I'm supposed to plot the graph with you guys, but I want to instill the confidence in you. I will urge you to plot the graph and tell me what your reading likes. Are you able to get a straight line or not? But I'm very sure it's going to give us a straight line because I already showed you the relationship between this and this. So, as always, thank you for watching and thank you for always. I really appreciate you guys. I really want your support more to share my videos within your colleagues. Let us reach up towards 10,000 subscribers. So if we are able to reach 10,000 subscribers, we are going to be able to communicate to ourselves freely by uploading what is coming on next, what is delaying the upcoming what event. We will be able to share that with each other. But currently, with the number of subscribers we have, we cannot really interact with each other. And that is why I will urge you, anything you have to say, always drop it in the comment section. But please and please be polite like you have always been. I will always respond to your question very fast. And for those that are asking me to make video on mathematics before Tuesday, wow, that is a very huge task for me to do currently because of my busy schedule. But I will try as much as I can to what to make videos on the said topic that you requested for, if possible, tomorrow. Otherwise, I wish you success in your exam. Have a nice day, guys. Love you.